Yeah, just prepare in general. Think, like I said, think ahead. Think about where you're going. Think about even the road trip there.
Yeah.
Think about all kinds of stuff. I mean, too many people don't think, and this is how accidents happen.
Yep.
This is how things happen when they're out, when they go out and they go camping and things like that because they're not prepared. How many people have gotten lost, or how many people have gotten hurt or like a simple cut?
Yeah. Yep.
Almost killed them because they didn't have anything with them.
Yep.
I mean, like I said, I get messages all the time about, well, don't you think you're being paranoid? No, I don't.
No.
I don't think that people are paranoid enough. And that's why, we have so many of our firemen and ambulance people out on a search and rescue.
Yes.
Or their people lost their damn leg because they just didn't use common sense stuff. And I'm not saying accidents can't happen because they absolutely can.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely.
But there's a lot of things that can be avoided. Yeah, that can be totally avoidable, too.
Yep.
So
again, rope comes in handy. Secure your food in between two trees. You fall in the lake or it rains, you're wet. Hang up your clothes. A rope is used for anything, believe me.
Exactly. Oh, yeah, paracord. Paracord is your friend, and it's cheap.
Yes. Yeah, exactly. Yes.
Paracord is like one of the strongest material you're going to find. It's not going to, it doesn't fray like rope does.
Yep. Yeah, there you go.
It's definitely your friend. It's so cheap. I mean, it's so cheap. Even to have just a little bracelet of the paracord bracelets, I mean, have those to prepare. Like I said, the whole point of the planet B.O.B. here is for people to be prepared.
Yep.
For you to rely on yourself. And I know I keep saying it, but to me, I can't say it enough. Insist upon yourself.
Yes,
stop
absolutely.
Stop relying on other people. Stop having that cushion that, oh, I've got my phone, so, I can just call 911. I don't need this.
Yep.
BS.
Yes. There you go. Exactly.
And your family. Stop doing that. There's so many people that do that, and that's how they get killed, because they don't understand.
Yep.
That these people aren't always going to be there. They may not be able to get to you.
That's right. You don't know how long it'll take. They might be busy helping somebody else. You don't know.
Exactly. Exactly. Or even if you can get a hold of them, there's a lot of places. Like I can tell you, there's a canyon outside of Amarillo. It's a huge canyon that you can't. A Caladuro Canyon. It's actually, I think it has something to do with it. It's bigger in Grand Canyon in some ways and not in others. But anyways, it's a huge canyon. You cannot get a signal in that damn canyon anywhere.
Yeah. Yeah, it's very true. Very true. Yep.
So, I mean, unless you're planning on going back to smoke signals, I mean, you need to be prepared.
Yep.
Prepare. Liquid. Make sure you have enough because dehydration is a real thing and it can happen very fast.
Oh, yeah.
Heat stroke.
Yes.
Can happen very fast. So that's just, like I said, this section here is all about preparing of things that you should be bringing with you. Then think about, and even think about little things like your food. Bring some salt, bring some pepper.
Yeah, yes.
That has nothing to do with survival, but it'll make your life a little easier, a little better.
Yeah, yeah. Here's something you don't think about, okay? Sometimes people go out, and they got to have the bonfire from hell out there, okay? Don't use up all your firewood. You're going to go out in the dark and look for twigs and stuff and wood? It's dark. That's when the critters are out. You can't see a bear. You might hear them.
But they sure as hell can see you.
You're darn right. Snakes are out there. You can't see anything. So, don't do that. But not only that,
to another thing to prepare for, flashlight.
Yes, flashlight, headlamps.
Lantern.
Yeah.
Make sure there's some that don't rely on batteries, like the crank lights.
Yes,
those are awesome. The solar ones, they're really awesome. Those little yard lights, those are great. People don't even realize the ones you can get at the dollar store, those little solar lights.
Oh, they're amazing. Yeah. I love them.
Put a couple around your campsite.
Mm-hmm.
Just hammer them right in the ground, right around your campsite, and then you're going to have a light at night.
Yeah. Headlights, headlamps. Those are good for going if you have to go out for something. Yeah, those are good.
Oh, yeah, so you need to have your hands free so you can
fight the bears.
Your little
girl. There, you can fight the bears, and you can see what you're doing. Yes. Yeah.
Okay, you would think I'm getting paid down, but I'm not. I'm not getting nothing. I absolutely love this product.
Yeah.
It's so great. I mean, it really is.
It
I
is.
Just think for like camping or like the other people like you have got me, that's a great thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Well, yeah. Okay.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, those crank ones are, they have come such a long way with this stuff that, you know.
Oh, yeah, they have.
So there's
they
a,
have. They used to be like you just had like a battery. They're like big old honking, what the hell size were those? They were like a brick.
Yeah. Those were.
With the launcher.
Yeah, and you better bring several.
They die after a day anyways. Yeah.
Yep, and you better bring several. Those were bulky, and you had to bring extra batteries. Oh, those, what a pain.
Yeah, bring some, and it sounds bizarre, bring those birthday candles with you, those little tiny candles.
Yeah.
Those are good, too, in an emergency situation. Know what you're going to come across. I know people that bring me an oil lamp with them.
Yeah, that's true.
You can do that.
Yeah. I like their, I have an old-fashioned lantern. Of course, you got to add the kerosene to it. But I love that thing. It lights up the whole area.
Yeah,
these
people are like the, what I call the crazy survival.
Yeah.
They're not crazy, but they're just super-duper ultra-prepared.
Yeah,
They always think about an EMP attack. If something happened to where EMP happened and, like, all the, you know, everything gets wiped out, like batteries, electronics, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Nothing you have is going to work.
That's right.
So they bring an oil lamp just in case something like that does happen.
Yeah.
So they have light at night.
Darn right. Darn right.
And always have preppers. A lot of preppers will definitely agree on this one. Make sure you have a get-home bag with you, which is basically a bag that can help you get back to your house if something happens to your car. Something does happen.
Good point.
You just never know.
Good point.
You just never know. I mean, people say, oh, that's not going to happen. I mean, and I'm one of those people generally, like, I don't prepare for the big ones just because I honestly don't think it's going to happen in our lifetime, but if it does, it's always a good thing to have, and it doesn't have to be one of the big ones. It can be something every day.
Yeah, exactly.
It can be your car breaks down.
Yep.
Your car breaks down, and nobody stops to help you. What then? What do you have with you? What can you survive on?
Exactly.
Because, again, you can't rely on other people. You cannot rely on the kindness of strangers, because sometimes strangers aren't that kind.
No. No, that's absolutely true. Yep, that just
happened. Yeah, like I said, prepare for anything and everything if you can while you're out camping. Just think about the big ones that happen, the everyday stuff with camping. Think about dehydration. Think about heat strokes. Think about all kinds of things, hypothermia. Think about even like if you have a medical condition, diabetes, make sure you have your medication.
Yes.
If you have high blood pressure, make sure you have your medicine. Make sure you have the things that you're going to need. And if you have anybody that's allergic to anything, I don't care what it is, make sure you've got that EpiPen on you. Make sure you have the Benadryl.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, you just never know what's going to happen out there. There might be something that someone in your family is allergic to, and you don't even know it.
Yeah, exactly.
What if your kid's never been stung by a bee, so you don't know if they're allergic to it or not?
Yep.
Also, if you're stung by a bee, they can't breathe, or they're swelling up, you know, bring something. And I know that EpiPens are expensive now, which that, to me, is a tragedy, and it's just ridiculous, because not that expensive in other countries. Don't even get me started on my opinion on that. But they are very expensive, but it's worth it to have one.
Oh, definitely.
Worth it to have one on you.
Yeah.
So
I totally agree with that. You just don't know.
there's just no reason for it to be that expensive.
No, I agree. Yeah, that could be our rant for the night. Yes. That's cool.
That's where me and Ike's conspiracy theories come in about that.
Yeah,
like, genetically modify all of our food, making allergies, just rampant, and then make EpiPens so expensive where people can't get them.
Yep.
Yeah, that's not a conspiracy, but anyways.
Yeah.
Rant over.
Yep. Yep, I totally agree there, so. Okay.
Yeah, if anybody thinks that the two aren't linked, you're nuts.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll get back to camping.
Okay.
Sorry, I had an Ike moment there.
But it's true. But it's the truth.
I'm one of the owners of the station here. Him and Stephen Clark are the station, and ideas have some really clear. Well, sometimes they're a little out there worse than me. I don't think there's anybody worse than me, but there is.
Yeah, there is. There is.
Gotta love them. But anyways. Camping,
okay.
Yes. Disasters while you're camping. Tornadoes.
Yes.
That's another thing. Look ahead. Look at your weather.
Yes.
You're going to be camping for 3 days. Look ahead 3 days at the weather.
Yep.
I mean, they're not going to have it to an exact science, but they're going to have a general idea of what's about to happen.
Yep, exactly.
So if they're going to need storms in the area, prepare to bug out if you have to. Prepare to find shelter. Prepare to do something to, again, save yourself.
Yep, absolutely. So.
Exactly. And you're going to take a break, and we come back.
We'll take
campfires and marshmallows.
Oh yeah. Sounds good to me.
All right.
Okay, we'll be right back, guys. Yeah. Oh, dear. So much fun. Oh, yeah, we got to go in our second spin.
Oh, yes, you're going to be doing your spin.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
You're by yourself.
Oh, no. That's right. I'm going to die. I'm going to die.
Find yourself a mess.
I know. What a mess.
But EpiPen, you're absolutely ridiculous right now. I couldn't even believe it.